Well, everyone, it is time once again for another episode of Brawl News. Thanks for stopping by. Hope you guys are enjoying your day today so far. You guys know Brawl News. It's your favorite spot to get all the interesting comings and goings in the Brawl community that you might not know about, but might want to know about. The catchphrase, baby. Today's episode is most definitely going to be an interesting one. Brawl Stars tweeting out on their social medias an awesome Easter egg, which they typically do a little bit before an update or something cool coming around the corner. So we're going to be breaking down all the smaller Easter eggs within that, what it might mean here leading into a potential update. Also, we have a few other things to touch upon other than the photos. So hope you guys are all pumped up. Let's get straight away into it. Here we go! So everyone, of course, if you enjoy these Brawl News episodes, consider subscribing. We are getting further and further away from our 50-50% not subscribed and unsubscribed goal here. If you guys have been enjoying my videos and aren't subscribed yet, it would be awesome if you do so. We're kind of rounding the corner to 300,000 subscribers, which is crazy. We should get there very, very soon. And I just want to say, even if you guys aren't subscribed, thank you so much for supporting me and watching my videos. It means a lot. And the other best way to support me, if you enjoy what you see here, is using code RAY in the Brawl Stars shop. You guys already know the dance parties keep a rolling all day when you're using that code RAY. So I greatly appreciate it. Thanks, guys. But with all of that out of the way, like I said before, the Brawl Stars dev team tweeted out earlier this morning, we're taking the day off with a very interesting teaser here, centralized around the whole cyberpunk theme. Now, the very first thing that I found incredibly bizarre about this tweet is they added a very popular game in the current game environment, and that is Cyberpunk 2077. I'm sure you guys have heard of it. I'm not gonna lie to you guys, I don't really keep up a whole lot with other games being released and stuff like that. All I really know is that a lot of people are talking about it, right? And it seems like the photo that was tweeted out by Brawl Stars is along that line, right? Cyberpunk 2077. They even used the font from Cyberpunk within the Brawl Stars teaser on the bottom right hand corner. Now, I don't know if that's like a collaboration or maybe the update is gonna kind of fit into that whole theme of 2077, like a futuristic cyberpunk environment. So again, we really haven't seen this before from Brawl Stars, so it's hard to expect what is going to come of this weird cyberpunk Brawl Stars 2077, right? So we'll have to keep note on that, and I'll keep you guys in the loop if anything develops on that. But breaking down the other things in the photo. So the very first thing my eyes drifted to in the photo is this Wi-Fi symbol. This is a symbol directly correlated with Starr Park. If you guys aren't caught up to date with that kind of stuff, we really haven't talked about Starr Park in quite some time because things have been very, very stagnant when it comes to news on them. We've seen this symbol a lot of times here in the community to the point where it's basically synonymous. When you see this, you think of Starr Park. We've seen it here for an example, a little Easter egg, as well as here, and now popping up once again in this sneak peek. So I think the biggest takeaway of seeing this in an actual Easter egg coming from Brawl Stars is that Starr Park is going to have some sort of role here, potentially in this next update coming around the corner or somewhere down the line, maybe in the future, right? So the text below it is a little bit cut off, but what people are thinking it is Barley's Bar open 24/7, dash Mr. P Stories 1904, and then Brawl-a-Days with the Y cut off at the end. Now there's a ton of really interesting things to take away from this. First things first, I don't think Barley's Bar open 24/7 means a whole lot. People are still kind of trying to figure that out at the moment, but what a lot of people are talking about is 19.04, which we've seen countless times. It's a very important date. The first time we saw 419 or April 19th was on this particular loading screen in the background on the scoreboard. People thought it was a date for an update or a PAM remodel coming around the corner, but nothing came. But what did start was the WKBRL live stream on April 19th, 2020. So my thinking is having the big Starr Park symbol there as well as April 19th popping back up again. I got a feeling we're going to have some resurgence with the WKBRL live stream and just Starr Park developments in general. And then at the very end, the Brawl-a-Days, of course, I think that's going to be what's coming here very shortly, right? The Brawl-a-Days update. And I mean, what's even more interesting is that we have Virus 8-Bit right above that, probably like the key brawler that's been talked about the most in theory crafting here in the community. community. And to round out the Star Park symbolism, we have another thing popping up, and that is SPEWD. Guys, SPEWD, a very important acronym popping up in the community, where I actually got a roll of SPEWD stickers sent to me during the whole Star Park arc, when things were kind of going haywire in the community. The acronym pretty much so widely agreed upon, meaning Star Park Union of Distressed Employees. So kind of like a union that is trying to fight against Star Park or fight for their rights. Future A popping in here for a quick minute before Pastor A goes over more in this photo. The only other thing that might be kind of Star Park related is in the bottom right hand corner of the image. It's very faint, but we have a poisonous gas, kind of synonymous with Star Park, right? With the poisonous spillage leaking into the sea and a bunch of poison gas references from Star Park related Easter eggs or advertisements here in the game. And the only other thing is that for the zero here in the 2077, the Brawl Stars logo or the skull has a weird little symbol above his head. But you guys can take that however you like. Let's move along with Past Ray with the rest of the photo. So now that we got the Star Park symbolism out of the way, next let's get into some of the key Easter eggs that people are discussing from this photo. The very first one and the most important one being, when is Brawl Talk? Now personally, I think this is just kind of feeding into the meme. Whenever an update is kind of coming around the corner, we get people saying this all the time. It's like a catchphrase at this point. When is Brawl Talk? But if you do look into it just a little bit further, you guys know your boy likes to put on the tinfoil hat every now and again. There is a reason they put this in the photo, right? Maybe they're using the meme to kind of mask the actual importance of the message. Maybe a Brawl Talk is coming around the corner here shortly. Which, a healthy reminder, we speculated to be somewhere around the Brawl Stars anniversary date. So that is December 12th. Moving along to the next really interesting thing a lot of people are discussing, and that is this new Brawl Stars logo in a graffiti theme, right? The very first thing I thought it was a snowflake without zooming in on it, which definitely makes sense. It's pretty much so recognized in the community that Brawl Days is going to be coming. We already have confirmation that some of the old Brawl Day skins are coming back for the very last time, the one for Dynamite, Nita, and Penny. So maybe we'll see a logo change or just kind of confirmation here saying that a snowy themed Brawl Day update is coming. Moving along here, we have more superhero references. I would say probably the most popular thing that we see in Easter eggs or artworks such as this is Max's energy or Max's logo posted everywhere, almost like she's the superhero that's fighting against the bad guys out there, as well as we have Surge at the very top versus Rosa. Not sure if this is anything super significant. It could just be kind of playing into this whole Brawl Stars World Finals trophy there, and then the Max's energy ad or whatever we saw in that World Finals advertisement. So a few things kind of related to competition or like the World Finals, right? We have a few other advertisements here as well. The spike cleats popping back up once again, and the cold coffee, I believe. We've seen this before, most definitely. The first time we saw all of these advertisements was when Colette was kind of coming around the corner, so quite a few months ago, but the Colt's coffee, or Brock's coffee there, it's Brock's coffee, there, as well as the spike cleats. I don't think anything really important is coming from these advertisements. I've been seeing some people thinking that these brawlers are getting nerfs because these advertisements in particular are making their way into this photo, but I think that might be looking a little bit too far into it. I think it's just there for the aesthetic, but moving along. Some of the graffiti here in the background behind BB, the very top one is BB's signature in graffiti theme, and then the one below it, which is cut off, a lot of people don't know quite yet. I think the second letter is an A, and then of course the last one is an M, so it could be Bam, could be Pam. What these mean, I'm not quite sure. All we can really take away from it at face value is that BB is getting a lot of references in this photo, right? She's literally standing in the middle of it. She's kind of like the symbol of Cyberpunk here in the game when she was released along with Tara and 8-Bit to celebrate Lunar New Year not too long ago. So maybe we'll be seeing this skin come back into rotation. I know a lot of people really enjoy it, and it is a limited skin. Really, the only other things we can take away from this is the Challenger Colt gun there on top of that skyscraper and this Leon hood with no Leon in it. So some people thinking that this is an advertisement for Leon's hood, but a Leon reference, which is really, really interesting. So I think that covers basically all the significant stuff. We also have 2077 there and Spike popping up, but those are all the main references I can pull away from it. Now, people are really going in deep to some of the things, and I wanted to save this towards the end because this is really tinfoil hat stuff. There's only two things in particular. The very first one being a few people thinking that the question mark, exclamation mark means 12-12, right? If you flip it upside down, which is the date a lot of people think that a Brawl Talk or an update is coming for this Brawl Days update. Again, that's looking kind of far into it, but hey, take it however you like. And then the final thing here, transitioning to Reddit, a post from RxSass, pointing out that Morse code might be a thing in the background on these skyscrapers. He actually did the translation and it came out to JLE. Nothing really comes to mind from that, but he mentioned that a few older YouTube channels popped up when you searched it. So don't know if that's anything significant, but we'll see. So then to wrap up this segment before we move on to the other stories in today's video, I think the major thing to take away from this is that Brawl Days is coming around the corner. We have that Brawl Days in the bottom left-hand corner, which is really interesting, as well as a Brawl Talk reference. I got a feeling Starr Park is going to have some sort of role in this next update, or very, very soon. This is the first time we've seen significant Easter eggs or symbolism from Starr Park, and having more than one in this photo is definitely kind of peaking my interest. And then the final thing is, of course, the theme coming from this, right? It's Brawl Stars 2077, a futuristic theme. A lot of people kind of confused because they thought this next update would kind of just go off of what we already have going on in the game right now, the Brawl Days, the Christmas vibe. We know the Christmas skins are coming back, but we might be wrong. We might see a futuristic theme, or we might get this Brawl Days update and the next Brawl Pass season will be centralized around this theme. I think that makes a lot of sense, though it's a very early sneak peek for something like that. But again, I would love to hear what you guys have to think about all this stuff and what you think the theme means. So moving along to our next bit of news here, definitely a lot of people talking about this in particular, and it's an ad that people are seeing on YouTube, Chief Pekka posting over here on Reddit, the actual ad that people are seeing. If you take a look at it, we have a very familiar game mode that we saw last Brawl Days season, and that is present plunder. So going off of what we saw with the last Brawl Days update for Halloween, we saw Graveyard Shift coming back, so I would assume it's very, very likely to see present plunder coming back to the game once again, which is freaking hype. A lot of people were also thinking that this was just the advertisement they used last year, but indeed it is not. We see Amber there at the bottom right hand corner of the screen, as well as Frank getting stunned with Lou's mechanic there. So this is recent gameplay. So with this, we can also see that Nita is going to be getting a buff if they don't change it, right? If this is dev build gameplay, all of that is subject to change, but she's dealing 1,232 damage to the Lou and the Frank. And the only other thing I want to bring up in today's video is that our favorite game lead, Frank, it's his birthday today. So guys, wish him a happy birthday. I don't think we could ask for a better game lead or just team that we have here for Brawl Stars. They do a phenomenal job and we're very, very lucky to have them. So wish him a happy birthday. That would be fantastic. But yeah, everyone, I think that's just about it for today's video. I really wanted to keep this basically going over the photo that they tweeted out this morning. I think a lot of interesting things are on the horizon, whether it's the Brawl Days update, getting these new skins coming back, or maybe a sneak peek for the next season here for season 5. Either way, it's really, really interesting. Also, be on the lookout for Starr Park around the corner. Guys, my eyes are going to be peeled on that WKBRL livestream. It's been a very long time since we've gotten some word from Starr Park or the live stream. So really, really excited about that. Also, just helpful reminders, make sure to mark your calendars. Guys, we're only 2 days away from the Brawl Stars anniversary. I'm assuming we're gonna get maybe a free gift or something along those lines. So keep your eyes peeled on that and I'll be doing the same and keeping you guys in the loop as best as I can. But yeah, everyone, I think that's enough. Hopefully you all enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to slap a like on it. I'd really appreciate it. With that being said, have a fantastic rest of your day and we'll see you in the next video. Peace out, you guys.